With many Chippewa players having aspirations of competing at the next level, Central Michigan football hosted their annual Pro Day on Friday morning. Afterwards, we caught up with a few of the guys to see how things went.
Today we did a lot of testing, a lot of running around with the pro scouts watching us, and it was a lot of fun. A little nerve-wracking at points, but it was really good. I think everybody performed well.
I remember being here, coming in as a walk-on, and going to my first pro day, not really knowing anybody. And it's always been a goal of mine, always been a dream of mine to come out here and be able to participate with all your best friends in front of all these pro scouts. It's a huge interview, and I think it went really well.
I made some of my numbers, and I went out there and tried my best. And it was nice to be out there with my old teammates and us having time to be together again and going competing.
Because I've been away from the guys so long, like, it was nice to finally see him, and we were all back grinding together, working together for this common goal.
That's one of the main things I'm going to miss the most, the camaraderie and the brotherhood that we had here. And to have all the guys back here, it was nice.
With his NFL experience, current Dallas Cowboy and former Central Michigan Chippewa Kayvon Frazier offered a helping hand to the current players looking to play at the next level.
Kayvon has been inspirational and huge for a bunch of guys, but for me especially. You know, I text him almost on a daily basis, you know, just to ask him about certain things that I'm feeling, certain things that if this is the way that he was feeling around this time, just because I've known Kayvon since high school, so it's nothing to text him and get some honest and truthful advice.
Kayvon's been instrumental. Kayvon and LT, I've been close with both of them, and they've both been instrumental in this whole process, kind of just making sure it's run smoothly and kind of giving you a heads up on kind of expect this and giving you little tips on how to go about stuff. That way it can go as clean as possible. I talk to Kayvon at least every 2 weeks probably, kind of just talk about what's going on and what I need to be doing, how I should be handling things. So they've both been huge. I'm grateful for both of them.
He's helped me a lot. I mean, he's always been there for me, whatever I need, you know, advice, just support. He's always been there for me. So it's nice to have an older guy like that to help me out in these situations.
But basically just keep your head. Like I said, it's stressful because you don't know what's coming next. It's a lot of stuff going on, a lot of moving parts, but you just don't know what's coming next. So just keep your head, stay focused, and stay in the moment.
After today's event, the participants' future is in the hands of the scouts. But each guy has the same goal. They want to keep playing football.
I mean, getting drafted, that's a lifetime dream. So to get drafted, hear your name called on that day, and know someone is taking a chance on you to come and play for their organization, I'm grateful however it pans out. I'm just excited to play ball and make it happen.
My goals, honestly, bottom line, is to continue my career, whether it be across the border or here in the NFL. I'm excited for any opportunity I get.
The ultimate goal for me is obviously to make a 53-man roster. You know, for me, making sure that I do everything it takes to, for when my number's called, when that day comes, where that they do call my name and I'm out there competing, you know, I'm just giving everything I can, you know, to make sure that I do make that 53-man roster and I'm in the NFL next year.
Go to the NFL, make plays, and just get opportunity. It's my main goal, and that's what it always will be.